back at Greenbrier. It's Tuesday, May 10th. It's 10:30 in the morning. It's already 73 degrees on what should be the hottest day of the year so far. And we're going to start our regular mowing routine and a few other chores today.
Another week, another day to mow. There are several carpenter bees around. It was overcast the whole way down here, but now we've got nice sunny skies. I'm gonna open up the pump room, see what kind of pressure we got. Forty-five. So good. Turn the pump on. And I'll unlock the bathroom. Sprayed ant spray, and it looks like we had a bunch of termites die. What a mess. Does it look like they're drilling anywhere? I'm hoping that stuff I sprayed on the eaves.
In that one of them right there?
Yeah, it's a start.
There's one over here too.
One up there trying to form something. A couple. Go back around, and now that I know that bug spray works, I'll spray the outside again. Well, it doesn't look like they're dead yet. I'll replant them. Well, doesn't look like any rabbits got to the lilies. Raccoon. Coondoo still there. Water's continuing to go down a little bit, just barely. But at least the fence stayed up this week. I don't see any sign of geese. Boy, the carpenter bees are everywhere. day. It's already 72 or 73. Hope to get the lawn mowed before it gets too hot. Looks like Dave's already mowed. See, there's a tree mark back here. When they were back here for the power company, that they didn't take them out. That one's leaning pretty good. Those wildflowers that are coming up. Not the kind I was wanting. Put this carpenter bee trap back up, and I'll start mowing. The mowing has begun. Here we are, show you the cherry tree. Cherries are forming on it. It is loaded. And I'm going to set you up here by the outhouse as we mow. I don't mind telling you, it is hot out here today. It's already 76 degrees, probably 77 by now, and humid. It's not quite noon. This is the warmest day of the year so far, or will be. With the fertilizer and the geese off and Connie mowing, front yard. Plus these lilies really look nice. I think we're going to go back and get a couple more to extend it down towards the pier a little bit. Those are the day lilies. I think we may, even though one of these irises had been dug up, it hadn't killed it. Probably the raccoons smelling something under it. So I think we may get some more, get a couple more for this. Beautiful, gorgeous day. We weren't working. I'm gonna have to spray again, see if I can't keep some of these carpenter bees off. There must be 15 or 20 of them around. Well, we're going to spray for bugs and carpenter bees, and the retiree is going to spray for weeds out in the driveway.
where I put those two Trex boards on the floating pier. There was some rot on one of the joists, and I just dug out the bad wood, but I did not replace the did not put a cripple on there. I'm going to try to put a cripple on there now. Take up those two boards part way to where I can get under them, and use a treated 2x4 portion of it as a cripple, and restore the support.
This video is going to end here. When I went back up to the pavilion, the retiree was on the phone with EMS from Princeton, and her mother had taken a bad fall and lacerated her face severely. So right after this, we started cleaning up all of our projects and then headed south to Evansville to the hospital. So this is where it ends. So until the next time, take care.